Got this shit again, homie. I can't fucking wait. We're the only people even doing it again.
I know, I mean, there's a couple people with some clown suits, but not really anybody's fucking doing anything.
It's hotter than fuck.
I can't believe there's so many people.
It is hotter than fuck.
What's up, homie?
Yeah, there's zero crowd. That's a nice
crowd. Well done, Gypsy.
Yeah, I know last year when I first did it, I had the,
You were here last year with the gun face?
Yeah, because I had the cheap-ass clown costume. It was a white shirt with a polka-dotted fucking T-shirt.
Shitty-ass paint?
Yeah, and I had this mask. No, I didn't do no backflip. No, that wasn't me. Hell no. I'll do a front flip any day, but not no backflip.
It's just a shitty-ass T-shirt.
It's in my cheap-ass clown costume, bunch of dots in this mask.
I remember.
Yeah, there was like 34 of us, like 32 of us last year.
And I had my sandals on, too. So I really didn't get to do much.
I had some fucking Velcro in that hour or whatever. It fucking blew the shoes out.
It's fucking Harley Davidson's that made it for the past 7 years out of the 8 years of the gatherings. They got their favorite Fago Armageddon that I've been in, and they still hold strong.
Where are you from, Owen?
Kentucky.
Indiana.
What's your name?
Pop-Tart.
John Knoxville.
Kind of knows who knows me, doesn't he?
Yeah. You wouldn't expect me to hold you that long, though, did you?
No, I didn't.
You look back, you said, I got him in 5 minutes. And I'm thinking in my head, no, I'm not going to let him get 5 minutes on me. Like, you had it.
One of the longest games. This is Johnny Knoxville. This is who I beat the first round in Into the Echo Side. But
you got to give me credit. It's my first time ever doing that.
I got knocked out in the second round by the guy called Rain Man. And he fucking won overall.
He won
the whole thing.
Oh shit.
Bullshit.
So the dude that you know, that he didn't win first or nothing?
No, all my Michigan crew didn't make it.
Oh no. What?
We all got knocked out the second round and then won the third.
What?
Yeah, that sucked. Hey man, good luck on Cold Clown Card, man.
You too.
It's gonna be us three. Hey,
look these at these fucking
people.
Winners.
Final this fucking is gonna be the final.
Fucking winners.
That's right.
Again. Woo, woo, woo.
Oklahoma motherfuckers! This is about to go down, you know what it's all about. You've lined up very conveniently in the shade. And usually there's the audience part over here. But I'm gonna address it right here. You guys know what you're competing for?
I know.
You guys know what you're competing for. The winners of this shit are gonna be in the Insane Clown Posse live stage show that concludes this epic gathering of the Juggalo, straight beaming at 17 and on that main stage. But the question is this, do you have what it takes? Because the experience, the drama, the danger, the intrigue, the suspense, it all goes down during that show. So there's a lot of subtle things that make being a stage clown so special. And we're gonna, if you listen closely to my instructions for each round, you will find the ultimate things you should be focusing on to get ahead. So, with that said, are you guys ready to fucking do this?
Yeah.
Dope. So the way it goes down is like this. This is Dance of the Wicked. You guys are gonna get live as fuck on this stage, dancing and jumping, doing your shit and freaking it. But we are gonna replicate the experience of being on stage with ICP. Madman Pondo and Jump Steady will be fucking bombarding you. All kinds of danger. Can you survive? We're about to find out. Let's get everybody on the motherfucking stage. You have 2 minutes once that beat drops to freak your shit.
Ready for the rumble in the world, the busters, you know me as a hustler. Tryna creep, make it big, make 6 feet pink. Gotta put them under, straight jacket, gonna be.
black nine. Better than my black transvestite. You gotta be down to bang bang. Come and get this teaching. Yes, I'm the
you're freaking it while you're living the danger and the dream. Our panel of esteemed judges, who I'm going to shine up a little bit later when there's more room on the stage, they're going to be handing out golden tickets. That's how you move to the next round. There will be 17 of these golden tickets distributed. As soon as you get that ticket, your work in this round is done. If you get a ticket, fade to the back. So with that said, you got 2 minutes to wreck fucking shop, wild out, dodge the bagel, beware of Ducky, and let's see this shit get motherfucking live, DJ Carlito. 2 minutes, motherfuckers, get up front, own that stage. Wall. If you don't got a ticket, we thank you for participating.
Thanks, Dougie.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. We're in the right neighborhood here. So where's... The unsung hero of the Juggalo community. My man is not just at the intersection right off the highway. He's also here holding it down all day on the stage, getting it spiffy clean for what is to be round two. For those of y'all who earned your golden ticket by straight up surviving the onslaught. Now listen to this. Round two is Faygo Flair. And what this all about is launching a Faygo from the stage. Key note. It is not about distance. It is about style. It is about flash. It is about shine. So you're gonna get to launch a 2-liter. Our judges panel are gonna give you a score, and then the highest scores, the highest 12 scores are moving forward. Hey, on the judges panel, I wanted to shout out, you may have seen some of his artwork literally everywhere because it's the dopest shit ever. The hottest shit to hit paper since hot ink. Give it up for my man, Tom Wood.
If you could help me.
One of the visionaries behind all the new incredible games coming out of the hatchet. Then, of course, it's hard to recognize her with so many clothes on. You often see her slammed out in a bikini, reading erotic literature backstage at Juggalo Championship Wrestling. Give it up for Natalie, the ring girl. And of course, when you do events like this, waivers actually do very little to protect anyone. That's why we have our own motherfucking jungle lawyer on the stage, ready to hold it down and fight the government at a moment's notice. Give it up for Farris! So that's it, guys. That's who's holding it down. We got DJ Carlito on the wheels of steel. The man himself. He does not sleep, he does not eat, unless it's gathering related. Show some love for my brother, Jump Steady. And with that said, the top 12 move forward. Launch your bingo from the stage. It's not about distance. You want to launch it as creatively, as fresh as you can. So one at a time.
I recently became involved with someone.
Go ahead, sir. Grab your fago from Jump Steady and launch that bitch. Judges, watch this shit. Did you know, my man, he's going to be excited to learn this. If you're wearing a clown suit, you get to throw two fagos.
Rock and ride.
Yep.
Dr. Fago.
All right. It's not about distance. Launch it creatively.
Pineapple orange. Chocolate cream puff. Ginger ale.
Let's see you launch it creatively, homie. Watch us.
That precious sauce. Juggalo juice. Crack that fat boy. Let it go loose. Drink it. Spray it. Whatever you use. Do it up like Joey and Big Joe Bruce. Put it up, kid.
I'm about to.
Moon Miss Blue. Here's what you do. Throw it up in the sky.
All right. If you already threw the fago, come over on this side of the stage. All right, you're number one, you're number two. Okay, come all the way over here. All right, next up we got contestant number three. Remember your number. Alright, who's left? Alright, hold on. If you guys have not launched, come over here. Number 7, number 8, number 9, number 10, 9, 10, 11, all right, 12, 13, cover down, all right, there we go, 1 to 13, judges, we need to know right now who the top winners are. We need... Okay. All right. So far in the lead, we got contestant number 2, step forward. Contestant number 3, step forward. Contestant number 4, step forward. Contestant number 5, step forward. Contestant number 9, step forward. Contestant number 10, step forward. And contestants number 12 and 13, step forward. All right, the rest of you guys, unfortunately, you have lowest scores, so you have been eliminated. Grab a water on your way out, and please exit the stage. All right, all you right now that are in the lead, step over to the side. You guys are gonna get your round next to see if you can beat these top contestants so far. All right. So. Nice. And the dance again. You can keep dancing all day and I think that'll be entertainment enough. All right. Step to the side. Contestant number 16, you are on deck. Oh, the little shimmy? That's what I'm talking about. And there it goes. The traditional corkscrew twist. All right, y'all. Our judges are going to compile the scores to give you the final winners. Everybody move to the back of the stage, please. Everybody move to the back of the stage. Perform on stage with the Insane Clown Posse as a Wicked Clown Saturday night during the main performance of Gathering of the Juggalos 2017 right here in Oklahoma City. All right, many would die for this opportunity. You cannot pay money for this opportunity. You can only win this flavor here at the Killer Clown Academy. All right.
Taking ninjas to school, Jump Steady.
Drum roll, please. The contestants are the winners for this round. Starting with contestant number 2, step forward. You have earned your place. Contestant number 3, step forward into the light. Contestant number 9, please step forward. You have won the round. Contestant number 10, step forward. Contestant number 10. Who is, there he is, yes. Contestant number 13, step forward. Contestant number 14, step forward. And of course, the magical number of this year's Gathering of the Juggalos. What other could it be but contestant number 17? Beaming at 17 right now. The rest of you, please exit the stage. Grab a water on the way out if you will. All right, KG.
Yes, sir.
We are moving into the next round, known as, it's simply known as Fago Relay. All right, for this round, two contestants will be eliminated. two contestants shall be eliminated. All right, this round is very simple. On stage here before me, you see the barrels marked with 17. All you simply have to do is get these 17 Faygos from one barrel all the way across the stage to the other barrel in the quickest time possible. You can use whatever clothes you have on. You cannot remove your clothing to create some sort of sling-carrying device.
And also, unlike primates, we do not condone the use of tools.
Right, no tools in this contest. All right. So starting all the way with my man here in the clown sheriff's outfit, Sergeant Grimes. Oh, cavity search. Officer, that's right. All right, he looks for drugs up your ass and he enjoys it. All right.
That's Scotty D's job.
So now, come over here. All right. All right. No, you can use your clothes. You can use your clothes as long as you do not take them off to create a sling device. All right, Pondo, you ready? Yeah. All right, do we have the timer? Who has the timer? You got it? Is it all set? It's all set. Okay, so Natalie the Ring Girl is gonna keep track of your actual end time. When the 17th Faygo hits the inside of this barrel, she will stop the timer and that will be your official time. Whatever top six have, the lowest times will move into the next round. All right, are you ready? Okay, ready? All right, on a count of three, you may begin. One, two, three!
Run it for my magic.
Jump steady in the dick, you are disqualified.
I'm not sure exactly. I'm not sure what happened there. Pondo with the assist. I'm not sure if that's legal, but I think the judges, yes, judges, thumbs up or thumb down. Was that a legal assist? That's illegal.
Oh.
Oh, shit.
Lawyer has ruled that bottle right. Was irrelevant.
All right. Unfortunately, that did not count.
It's been stricken from the record.
It's been stricken from the record. Grab a water, you'll go to the end of the line.
Sail on a ship, it's gonna carry him across the Faygo surface.
All right, okay, are you ready? On the count of three, we will begin. One, two, three! Go, 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 go! Utilizing some sort of bear hug technique.
I've seen children leaving 7-Eleven holding more figures than that.
Mark the final times. Okay.
That's a case study in appropriate footwear. Some would argue leather moccasins are not appropriate for any festival, but certainly least appropriate for this environment.
Putting the pressure on, we have just revealed for the judges that only the top five will move into the next round. So you're going to try to have to work extra hard if you are to succeed at the Killer Clown Academy. Pondo, you
you're ready with the fango. Let's get the next contestant up here. Please move forward. Interesting. Oh, sorry, five. Okay, if you already win, move over here to this side of the stage. Okay. Contestant number five with the clown mask. Not really sure if that's a benefit here, but I gotta give you heart for wearing the mask during this event. It's gotta hinder your breathing.
That's what happened upstairs.
Right.
That's what was happening upstairs.
Is that true? The judges are insinuating they might give you a 5-second credit. I don't know if this is true or not.
Purely speculation. But,
he is simulating the real deal here. All right, on the count of three, are you ready? Killer Cloud, are you ready? Here we go. 1, 2, 3.
Here we go.
He has some kind of weird duck walk going across the stage. A whole new technique we haven't seen here before, KG.
Wow. Full bracing required here.
Slamming into those barrels,
these heavyweight bins.
All right, gotta get them all on this final attempt. If not,
this is gonna be do or die.
It really is. And he left one behind.
Never leave a Fago behind.
All time, that is time. All right. I'm not quite sure how he fared up with that round. He had a quick stumble early on in the beginning, and then he left one at the very end.
Wow.
All right.
In the heat of battle, you have to make decisions, Rob Bruce.
I know. You got to be quick on your feet. That's what it's going to take. All right, contestant number six, are you ready? All right, he's got the Carnival Carnage charm around his neck, giving him alternate karma for this event. All right, judges, you ready for this? Timer's ready. On the count of three, we shall begin. 1, 2, 3. Here we go.
Using the slow clapping style. Straight 17 and in that Oklahoma sun, formerly known as contestant number 17, shortened now to contestant number 7.
Whoa, and my personal favorite. Quickly moved across the stage. Very, 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 very impressive.
We're supposed to be impartial, but I also too very clearly have a favorite. I'm biased.
She did not lose energy that whole round.
No, none.
I've seen every other tire near the end. The pace was the same the whole time.
She could have kept carrying those Fagos for like 45 minutes.
Give it up to my man right here for the slow, steady approach that others quickly copied. The technique was very impressive. All right, you all have earned your spot. Y'all are here for the ultimate challenge and to win the right to be on stage with ICP tomorrow night.
And just for grins, who do y'all think had the very best time of anyone? The best time of any of these guys? Who was it?
I'm going to go with 17. Even with the extra round, I'm going to go with 17.
The truth of the matter, hold on. The truth of the matter is the person with the shortest time is this motherfucker right here.
Oh, taking the number one spot. All right, for this next round, KG.
Yes, sir.
This next round, if you'll notice out on stage, you will see platforms with 6 Fago 2 liters firmly perched on top. You will have, one at a time, each contestant will take one of the super soakers. You will have to knock every single target off the stage. You don't have to knock it off the platform, you just have to knock it down. Okay? And this will be a timed event. Natalie, with the stopwatch, will time you to see how long it takes.
And you are free, contestants, to move about this stage if you choose to. You don't have to be married to this bucket. But you may want to be close to your bucket. You tell us how you want to do it.
Okay. The third contestant. Oh, thank you. The bagels are in place.
The judges are in position.
You know, I want to say, KG, of these five Fagos that are out here, one is particularly troublesome.
I don't know if it's the hype or the way the wind moves through this unique domed custom-built structure, but there's something about that dirty bottle.
You know, and it's the highest on the platform. You think it'd be the easiest because it's the level with the stage.
The higher you get off the ground, the more the wind currents change. This is the most challenging course at the gathering.
You know, because you're shooting low, low, and when you go high, it completely fucks you up. You're not used to it. It's a whole new dynamic. It just throws you completely off.
You can't train for this. You cannot recreate this unique environment.
Three.
Go, 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 go.
Oh, holy shit. No, he could go all the way.
He's got to switch all the way across the stage with the
oh
reach.
Oh, my God.
Going for distance. Oh, that's what I'm talking about right there.
That could be a record-setting run on this course.
Women in 17, you are victorious. You have made it through the field of about 60 killer clowns to stand here as one of the ultimate winners. Congratulations to you. She started online under those trees, and now she's about to make history. Best time in the contest, shot with ICP tonight. Unprecedented.
All right. And next up, my man. Okay, my man, with, I believe, the best time.
Hold on. Stand by.
Y'all give it up for this wicked clown academy, killer clown academy! Congratulations, you are victorious.
History has been made. Three incredible family members step up onto the main stage tonight to unleash Fagel with insane clown posse.
We would like to thank